You are now watching Islam. Don't.
لله عبادا فطنا طلقوا الدنيا وخافوا الفتنا نظروا فيها فلما علموا أنها ليست لحي وطنا جعلوها لجة واتخذوا صالح الأعمال فيها سفنا.
The Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, whomever will come from the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in a gathering, reading the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, studying the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, eating from the meals of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, smelling from the flowers of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It's one of Allah's grants to that gathering, to be surrounded by the angels, which we have been looking for, to be overshadowed with the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which we have been missing in many of the aspects in our life. We have been complaining about tens of aspects. We have been complaining about sustenance. We have been complaining about wives. We have been complaining about families. We have been complaining about economy. We have been complaining, we have been complaining, we have been complaining, and we are in a place. Allah is granting the attendees to be overshadowed with Allah's mercy. Subhanahu wa ta'ala jalla wa ala. And the tranquility which we have been missing as well. Nowadays, in individuals, with families, with communities, and in the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, find me a place on the whole globe where the banner of La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah is at. And you will go there and you will not find a complaint. And you will not find a wound in the body of the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Tell me, where is that place? Any place, even among the areas that's claimed under the Islamic countries. The wound is almost everywhere. The injury is almost everywhere. Even within the communities of Muslims. And sometimes the wounds and injuries are coming from one another. Between one another. The conspiracies against one another. And we'll see inshaAllah subhanahu wa ta'ala within the discussion and within the interaction that most of the complaint we used to have, we have never complained from ourselves. We always complain from others. Who wanna throw the balls in their yards and mush our hands so we are not even a part of the crown. And we'll conclude inshaAllah subhanahu wa ta'ala by the end of the session that whenever there is a problem in the body of the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whenever there is a problem with an individual, whenever there is a problem with the family, whenever there is a problem with the community, whenever there is a problem with the country, whenever there is a problem with the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you will find that the deep or the root cause behind the problem is the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It's Muslims. And you will see that in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And it was very simple. And one of the triggers that we should not forget, one of the ahadith of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. And the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam knows what's going to happen as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did reveal to him. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given that hadith to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It's a hadith of Qudsi. And the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, Ana malikul muluk. I am the king of the kings. فَلَا تَنْشَغِلُ عَنِّي بِسَبِّ الْمُلُوكِ. Don't keep busy or just spend your time insulting the kings, the rulers, the bosses, the managers. فَلَا تَنْشَغِلُ عَنِّي بِسَبِّ الْمُلُوكِ. Don't spend your time in insulting others, washing your hand, throwing the ball in somebody else's court. And he has set up the phenomena that will be applied since then till the day of judgment. فَإِنْ أَطَعْتُمُونِي سلطت عليكم من يخافني ويرحمكم، وإن عصيتموني سلطت عليكم من لا يخافني ولا يرحمكم. If you obey me, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I'm gonna empower, I'm gonna bring upon you, I'm gonna send the ruler, the boss, the top of the system. And that system can be small, can be big, it can be your own flat or apartment, it can be your own family, it can be your own community, it can be your own city, your own country, the whole ummah. And it will be applied the same way. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, فَإِنْ أَطَعْتُمُونِ If you will obey me. It's that simple. I'm going to bring the top of the system. صَلَّطُ عَلَيْكُمْ I'm going to bring the sultan, the president, the ruler. مَنْ يَخَافُنِي وَأَرْحَمُكُمْ The one who fears me and provide mercy upon you. وَإِنْ عَصَيْتُمُونِ And if you will disobey, you will violate the rules. صَلَّطُ عَلَيْكُمْ And in each one of them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, I am the one. The ruler is not coming. The ruler is not coming. The ruler is brought, not by elections, via our deeds. صَلَّطُ عَلَيْكُمْ مَنْ لَا يَخَافُنِي وَلَا يَرْحَمُكُمْ And if you will disobey me, the one that will become through me to be the top of the system will be the one who will not fear me and he will not provide mercy upon you as one of Allah's punishment to those who are disobeying Allah. I understand that the title that has been announced is under Ibad al-Rahman. And actually, when I have given the title to be the title of the lecture, it was not in my mind to talk about the attributes of Ibad al-Rahman. But inshallah subhanahu wa ta'ala will address them, because that's not the issue. And we'll see inshallah that those few verses at the end of the chapter of Al-Furqan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is starting, وَعِبَادُ الرَّحْمَنِ الَّذِينَ يَمْشُونَ عَلَى الْأَرْضِ هَوْنًا وَإِذَا خَاطَبَهُمُ الْجَاهِلُونَ قَالُوا سَلَامًا, till the end of the verses. My main goal behind the title is not what will come after Ibad al-Rahman, is what's under Ibad al-Rahman itself. Because you will see again by the end of the session that whatever is coming after Ibad al-Rahman is the fruit. It's nothing you have to deal with. It's coming out of anyone. He will be able to apply the requirement of Ibad al-Rahman, not the other way. Some people are thinking that whomever will fulfill those attributes, he is from Ibad al-Rahman. And if you go through any one of them, all of them could be applied on some of the non-Muslims. Is it true? Humbleness could be applied or not. Not committing adultery could be or not. Could be or not. Fearing what he wanna call it, Allah. The people of scripture are claiming the same. Not to be among those who are gonna witness, just be among false witness. It can be applied. That is the reason Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made them adjectives. It's like as a default smell of jasmine. That's the default. You are not the one who is adding the smell to the flower or the rose. Once you have jasmine in your hand, you will get the smell. And it's the same exactly. And all of those attributes are not even all attributes. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given them, and they are some of all. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given a sample of each one of the categories. Whomever will be called under the category of Ibad al-Rahman, that's what you are expecting out of. And that's a sample out of many. Let's make sure that we'll not leave the session.